Hello everyone, our topic is IPv4 header. Today I'll give you a brief idea about this IPv4 header. See, from next video onwards, I'll discuss every topic, means every field in details. And this video, I'll discuss about the bits and about the header length. The first field is version. Version is 4 bits. It is 4 bits. See, what I'm writing here, everything is in bits. Version is 4 bits and version is used for example, we are using IPv4 version. IPv6 is coming soon. The next field is header length. See, header length is again 4 bits. Header length is again 4 bits. Then type of service. Type of service is again 8 bit. It is 8 bits. Then total length. Total length is 16 bits. Total how many bits? Total 32. Total 32 bits. Then in the second row, you see identification. See, it is 16 bit. It is 16 bit. And it is used to number every datagram that is going out of host. It is used to number every datagram that is going out of host. See, then it is the 0 bit. Means this bit is not used. This, it is 1, means it is 0 bit, means only 1 bit, it is not used. Then comes DF and MF. This DF is 1 bit, MF is 1 bit. See, both these two are flags. Both these two are flags. And DF is, means do not fragment, MF is more fragment. DF means do not fragment, MF means more fragment. Then comes fragment offset. Fragment offset is again 13 bits. 13 bits. Total again 32 bits. Not bytes, it is in bits. Then comes TTL. TTL is again 8 bits. 8 bits. See, it is used to discard the packet which is going into infinite loops. It is used to, TTL means time to live. It is used to discard the packet which is going into infinite loops. Then protocol. Protocol is again 8 bit. Headers checksum, it's again 16 bits. Then source IP comes, it is 32 bits, destination 32 bits. Then comes options, then comes the actual data. See, before data, we have to add this, up to this we have to add. Up to destination IP address minimum means, up to minimum header length means, minimum header length should be up to, let me see, it is 32. It is 32. Everything is in bits. Then how many bytes? 32 bits means 4 bytes. 4 bytes. 32 bits means 4 bytes. So, leaving options, we have how many rows? See, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So, we have 5 rows. Means leaving option, we have 5 rows. So, 5 into 4 means 20. So, minimum header length should be, see, minimum header length should be 20 bytes. 20 bytes. Minimum header length should be 20 bytes. And what is the maximum header length? See, maximum, see, option is optional. Means option is optional. It ranges 0 to 40 bytes. 0 to 40 bytes. See, all other in bits and it is in bytes. So, option is optional. So, if we add option in host case, if we add option, then maximum will be, maximum header length will be 20 plus 40 equal to how many bytes? 60 bytes. So before data, means before data, the header minimum length should be 20 bytes if you are not taking options. And if you are taking options, then maximum header length will be 20 plus 40 equal to 60 bytes. Okay. Now see, we understand about header length. See, header length is 4 bits, so we'll understand now. See in your exam, if data is given like this, header length is 20 byte, 32 byte, 40 byte, then what should be the header length field? See, this is given header length, means actual header length is given, and if they are asking to find out the header length field, then how can we find out? See, the given header length is 20 bytes, and we have seen in the header format that header length is 4 bits. So what we'll do, see, we'll divide this number by 4. We'll divide this number by 4. Then what will be the answer? It is 5. Means header length field is 5. Then header length is 32. Then after dividing, how much we get? We get 8. And when it is 40, how much we get? We get 10. Now in your exam, how can you understand if in the question it is given header length or header length field is given? Then how can you understand? You can understand by seeing the range. See, the range is from 20 by to 60 by. 20 by to 60 by, then it is means you will understand that it is actual header length is given. And if the range is from 5 to 15, then you'll understand it is header length field is given. And you have to multiply with 4. So that to get the actual header length. See, if in your question it is given like this, if the header length field is given 5 to 15, then you have to multiply. See, if it is given 6, then you have to multiply 4. You have to multiply 4 with 6 to get the actual header length. Okay. So you can understand by seeing the ranges. Now the next interesting question is here. See, in worst case, how many bytes we can add? For example, if the actual header length is 20 bytes, then if we divide it by 4, then how much we get? We get 5. Means we don't have to add any dummy data. See, then if the header length is 24 byte, then if we divide it by 4, see, it's a multiple of 4. If we divide it by 4, then we get 6. So it's also okay. Now in worst case, how many bytes you should add? See if the header length is 21 byte, 20 is divisible by 4, 20 is a multiple of 4, so it's okay. See, if it header length is 21 byte, then the next multiple is 24. Then how many bytes you should add with 21 to get 24? You are understanding, no? If it is 21 byte, then how many bytes we should add with 21 to get a number which is a multiple of 4, that is 3. So 3 is the answer here, because 3 is the worst 3 bytes is the answer here, because 3 bytes is the worst case we should add as a dummy data. See, for example, if I take 25 and if I add 3, we get 28. So to get multiple of 4, we have to add maximum in worst case, that is 3 bytes. So 3 bytes is the dummy data. Dummy data means padding, means we are adding dummy data. Okay, so that it can be multiple of 4. Okay, thanks for watching. Thank you.